warning, car plows through pro-immigration mob outside GOP office, this could be a false flag. On Thursday afternoon, America witnessed what could have been the grim reenactment of the tragedy in Charlottesville, when a car hurled into a crowd of leftist protesters and killed a woman. Los Angeles Times reports that another vehicle drove through a mass of protesters outside GOP Representative Ed Royce's office in Brea. No injuries were reported to the police as of this time, and America is breathing a collective sigh of relief. Watch the video, you'll see how the protesters went completely out of line, and practically turned the whole intersection into a no-go zone. They deliberately exposed themselves in the worst possible way, just to make one of their adversaries react. The immigration fanatics had blocked the streets to traffic, you can hear drivers blaring their horns and yelling out their windows, but the leftists continued their pointless display of marching around circles, utterly heedless that the rest of America have jobs to work in places they need to be. As soon as one car began to nudge its way forward, the vicious mob pounced on him. One protester leaped onto the hood, and they descended on the car, beating it with their pathetic little sticks. If you watch closely, there is a point where one can see what could be cracks on the car's windshield. A lot of Americans can't help but wonder if these leftist lunatics had it coming to them. Radical left-wingers are always pushing our buttons, they heckle us, push us around until they can provoke a reaction that the media will pounce on. They did it at Trump rallies, and now they did it in Los Angeles, too. Imagine if this had turned out far worse, what if someone were killed? You can count on this, the bloodthirsty Democrats and their leftist propaganda machines would have gleefully broadcast the event for years to come. Ah, yes, another violent Trump supporter has come out of the works, the perfect chance to tar feather and shame everyone who voted for him. The suspected driver, Daniel Wensk, 56, of Brea, was arrested on suspicion of assault with a deadly weapon. Ed Royce was quick to denounce the driver's actions, stating that he condemns in the strongest possible terms any and all violence and that his staff remain committed to meeting with all constituents who wish to voice their opinions in a civil and respectful manner. Now let's wait for the denunciation that will come from the Democrats. Let's hear how much liberals disapprove of the conduct these pro-immigration barbarians used to convey their anti-American message by blocking traffic and destroying public order. You can bet there won't be any.